Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it.
Your name, your name, O Lord. Glory to your name, your name, O Lord. In heaven and on earth, glory be to your name. In heaven and on earth, glory be to your name. Honor to your name, your name, O Lord. Honor to your name, O Lord. In heaven and on earth, honor be to your name. In heaven and on earth, honor be to your name. Brethren, I welcome you to the presence of the Most High this day, Thursday, 15th of February. We'll be talking on the topic that says, the compassionate persecutor. The compassionate persecutor. But before we go into that, I want us to take a few prayer points from our prayer outlines. I want us to start by thanking God for another opportunity to be a partaker of this spiritual exercise. Let's bless God because sickness have not hindered you from being a partaker. The devil have not cheated on you from being a partaker. The Almighty God has helped you to be part of this spiritual exercise. Bless his name. It's not by power, it's not by might. He's the giver of grace. Let's bless his name. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Thank you for not allowing anything to hinder me. Oh God, I appreciate you. In Jesus' name we pray. Now you want to say, Father, safeguard your children from accidents this year. Every child of God that we travel this year by road, by air, on water, that the Lord will safeguard us. Pray in the name of Jesus. Father, my God, safety belongs unto you. We commit all of us, your children, into your hand this year. Safeguard us as we travel this year in the name of Jesus. Safeguard us, my Father. Every bona fide child of God, by whatever means we'll be traveling this year, either on land, on water, or in the air. Oh Lord God Almighty, safeguard us. Safeguard us, safeguard us, safeguard us, safeguard us, safeguard us. Our plane will not crash land. Our planes will not be hijacked in the name of Jesus. Our vehicles will not be involved in accidents in the name of Jesus. Oh, there will be no shipwreck in the name of Jesus. Legere baba bashanda ya ya baroko topoliaba regeke porobo sototolia dalileke speketenda. In Jesus' name we pray. We want to say, Father, let every blood-sucking demons on our highways be put to shame this year. Eternal Rock of Ages, let every blood-sucking demons on all our highways, all those demons responsible for car accidents, lima mama mama, all those demons responsible for vehicle accidents, le korobo shandara bababa, put them to shame, put them to shame, put them to shame, put them to shame this year, put them to shame this year, put them to shame. In Jesus' name we pray. We want to say, Father, be a wall of fire round about us against blood-sucking demons this year. Our Lord and our God, we want you to build a wall of fire round about us. Every child of God, this very year, build a wall of fire round about us against every blood-sucking demons, that no demon will be able to suck our blood this year. In the name of Jesus, because your blood, the blood of Jesus, is flowing through our veins, no demon will be able to suck our blood this year. In the name of Jesus, you want to say, Father, let your angels go with us wherever we go this year. La da yan ya gaga galibra ma santa ya gadin raga torombo dondorila mama seke den de libra ma kakoromo no yeketendo zupra baba 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 balila ya ya kakanderebo mosto plolo no yekekere bebe kesedia. You have promised to keep our going out and our coming in. Jehovah God, we are praying and we are pleading that you allow your angels, your holy angels, to be our personal bodyguards throughout this year. In the name of Jesus, wherever we go in life this year, let your angels be our bodyguards. In the name of Jesus, Lekorobo Sunto. In Jesus' name we pray. Prayer answering God, we thank you. Every prayer point we have raised now, turn them to testimonies in Jesus' name. Specifically, we join our faith together to pray for our Father and the Lord, your Son, Pastor Enoch Adejare Adeboye, as he travels around the world for you this year. Keep him safe in Jesus' name. Keep him safe in Jesus' name. Protect and shield him in Jesus' name. As Mama, the wife, also travel for your work this year, throughout 2018, as she travels by air, as she travels on water, as she travels on road, Lord, our blood will not be spilled in the name of Jesus. Our blood will not be spilled in the name of Jesus. Our blood will not be sucked by any demon in the name of Jesus. You will hide her under the blood in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus that no force of darkness can tolerate will be a covering over this family of God in Jesus' name. All together, none of us will be visited by evil this year in Jesus' name. In all our journeys this year, you will keep us company. And as we go into your word, give us an understanding heart to understand your word again. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Be assured, brethren, you are secured in his hand. Throughout this year, Jehovah will protect you. He will safeguard you. You will not walk into dangers. In the name of Jesus, your plane will not crash land. Your vehicle will not be burnt. Your vehicle will not have accident. In the name of Jesus, you will travel on water. There will be no shipwreck. In the precious name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for joining me to say those few prayer points. Now, going back to the topic of the day, the compassionate prosecutor. Memory verse. And when he is come, he will reprove the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. Our text is taken from John 16, 7 to 11. John 16, 7 to 11. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come into you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. And when he is come, he will reprove the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. And of judgment of sin, because they believe not on me. Of righteousness, because I go to my Father and ye see me no more. Of judgments, because the prince of this world is judged. Looking at the title of today's study, you may begin to wonder how a person can prosecute a case and be compassionate at the same time. But looking at the name of our Lord, you will know that this the Lord Jesus Christ is both described as the Lion of the tribe of Judah and at the same time is the Lamb of God. What a combination. A lion that roars ferociously and a sheep, easygoing animal. Is the God of love, at the same time, a consuming fire. Only in the Trinity can you find this kind of combination. So being a prosecutor and at the same time be a compassionate prosecutor, this is ironic because a prosecutor is expected to press the case for the law to have its full course. This fellow is in the wrong. I demand justice as a prosecutor. You will press the case until the law will have its full course. But at the same time, this prosecutor we are looking at is a peculiar prosecutor because he's compassionate at the same time. How do we marry the two? Who then is this prosecutor who manages to indict and show compassion all at once? The Lord Jesus Christ answers this question in today's memory verse. The person he refers to is the Holy Spirit. He's the one who will convince you of saying what you have done is in the wrong. And he's the one pleading with you, change your ways. Don't be destroyed. Sin kills. Based on this revelation of the Lord, that is the Holy Spirit, that is the compassionate prosecutor, let us consider the three-pronged strategy by which the Holy Spirit carries out his assignment of prosecuting the world. How does he do his work? Note, first of all, that it is compassion that motivates the Holy Spirit to prosecute the world while there is still time to make amends. The gate of mercy may close. Seek Jesus today. No longer delay. The gate of mercy may close. The Holy Spirit is the one prosecuting, convincing you of your sins, telling you the way you are going is the way of death, telling you, hey, this is a dangerous venture. Turn to God. It's one who will condemn you that, you have done this evil. This act of yours is evil. And your heart will be beating fast. This one is bad. This thing is bad. This thing is bad. That thing you have stolen is, does not belong to you. You shouldn't have stolen it. You are causing another man pain. The Holy Spirit convicts the world of sin. And at the same time, what makes him to do that is because of his compassion. Because he knows that the wages of sin is death. He knows that it is only when you are alive, there is still breath in your nostril, you can make amends. Hebrews 9:27. It is appointed unto man once to die, after that the judgment. That's why the Holy Spirit is convincing the world. Don't wait till you die. This path you are towing will end in hell. These sins that is part and parcel of you will eventually destroy you. Change now that there is still time. God is merciful, is willing to cleanse you with the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son. That compassion that motivates the Holy Spirit to motivate the world while there is still time to make amends. A time will come when the whole world we stand before the throne of Christ to be judged of their works. 2 Corinthians 5:10. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 10. At that time, you cannot repent again. It will be time for judgment. And that's why the Holy Spirit is convincing everyone now that repent while there is still time. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body, according to that he hath done, whether it be good or bad. All must appear. It has nothing to do with your religion. As long as you are created by God, if you are his handiwork, you are part of his creation, you will appear before him on the last day. And when you appear before Christ on the last day, that will not be a time for repentance. It's not a time that I'm sorry. Jesus, have mercy on me. The gate of mercy will have closed then. It will be time for judgment. That's why the Bible says, you will now appear before him to receive reward. You will be judged according to what you have done, whether it is good or bad. So the Holy Spirit is convincing the world of the bad things now, so that on the day of judgment, they might not be put to shame. So it's compassion that makes him to send a warning. There will be no excuses permitted on that day, that is on the day of judgment, because the compassionate prosecutor will have already given each man a dress rehearsal of what will happen in heaven's court. You are hearing it now. When you appear in the court of heaven, it will be time to receive judgment for whatever you have done, whether good or bad. The first of the Holy Spirit's three-pronged strategy is to make the world aware of the destructive nature of sin and cause each and every one to run away from it. That's why when you hear the word of God and the Holy Spirit is at work, your heart melts like wax before fire. I remember the day I gave my life to Christ. I watched a drama, heaven or hell. All of a sudden, the Holy Spirit made me to see my lifestyle. It was totally in agreement with that fellow who ended up in hell. He convinced me, and all of a sudden, when they gave the altar call, I ran to the front, I knelt down, I broke into tears. I began to cry. Nobody beat me. The word of God found me out. I started crying. Father, forgive me. If truly there is hell, I don't want to go to hell. Lord Jesus, I don't want to go to hell. Show me mercy today. I don't want to go to hell. Mercy, Lord. Mercy, Lord. I don't want to end in hell. That's the work of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will convince you. It convinces the world of sin. But sometimes when he convinces some of us, we refuse to yield. You say, am I the only one do it? Who has ever been to hell? Who have ever been to heaven? Leave me alone. Let me enjoy my life. Some will say, I'm still young. After all those people carrying Bible around, if you look at them, they are old people. After they have done all sorts of things. Let me too commit sins first. And later on, I will change. Say so. You better run to Christ when the Holy Spirit is still being compassionate, convincing you of sin now before it is too late. And there's a sound of warning here for those of us who are preachers. We should tell the people the truth of the word and let them know the pending doom that awaits every worker of iniquity. Let them know the pending doom that awaits everyone that is living in sin. Because some of us today, we tend to be preaching what the people want to hear. That might be dangerous. That's not the way the people of old did it. The disciples of old, they preached the undiluted word of God. The early disciples allowed the Holy Spirit to do this work through them. An example of the result is glaring in Acts 2:37. When they showed the people about the impending doom, take for instance John 3:36, what does it say? If you're a preacher of the word and you let your hearers know this,
definitely they want to run to Christ. John 3:36 says, he that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life, and he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him. Whose head is big enough to carry the wrath of God? I've not seen one human being strong enough to carry the wrath of God. So we need to let sinners know that if they fail to change, doom is waiting for them. Acts 2:37, the result of the disciples' preaching. Now, when they heard this, they were pricked in their hearts and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? What was it that they had? They had the raw word of God. They heard about the doom awaiting sinners. Take, for instance, Psalm 9, verse 17. As you are a preacher preaching the word, let sinners know this. Psalm 9, verse 17 says, the wicked shall be turned into hell, and all the nations that forget God. All. The wicked shall be turned into hell. Everyone that forgets God will end up in hell. Let them know. Don't just tell them sugar-coated things. Let them know the pending doom that awaits anyone who will refuse to be born again. John 12:48. John chapter 12, verse 48. What does it say? He that rejected me and received not my words, hath one that judgeth him. The word that I have spoken, the same shall judge him in the last day. Let sinners know that. If they reject his word, this same word that they are rejecting will be what will judge them on the last day. 1 Corinthians 4:5. 1 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 5. Therefore, judge nothing before the time until the Lord come, who both will bring to light the hidden things of darkness and will make manifest the counsels of the heart, and then shall every man have face of God. All the hidden things they are doing, all the sins they are committing in the secret now, let them know a day is coming, a day of revelation, when God will bring everything to the limelight. What of Revelation 20:15? Let sinners know about this. Revelation chapter 20 and verse 15, it says, and whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. The same Revelation 21:27. Revelation 21:27. And there shall no wise enter into it anything that defileth, neither whatsoever worketh abomination or maketh a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's book of life. And finally, Revelation 22:15. For without our dogs and sorcerers and warmongers and murderers and idolaters and whosoever loveth and maketh a lie. Because some say it's only lies now. And business lies. The Bible says, whosoever loveth and maketh a lie. We spend eternity where? We spend eternity in hell. Tell them. The second arm of his strategy is to make the whole world see the need to be upright in heart and the need to be in right standing with the righteous God through the mediator of new covenant, Jesus Christ. Thirdly, the Holy Spirit's work to make the world aware of the judgment and punishment that await the devil and his cohorts, like I've said earlier on. He does this so that men may be wary of listening to the devil and avoid being condemned along with him. The compassionate persecutor speaks truth to all those who will listen and be free from the eternal consequences of God's judgment, according to John 16:13 and John 8:32. How friendly are you with the Holy Spirit? Do you only love him because he comforts you in times of distress? Or do you still love him when he probes into your life and reproves you and encourages you? To make the Holy Spirit your senior partner, guide, mentor, and confidant, He will never lead you astray. Prayer point. Compassionate Holy Spirit, please strongly reprove the people in my locality of sin, of righteousness, and of judgment, and let your work of conviction have free course in their hearts in Jesus' name. Tell the Holy Spirit to do His three work. Convince people of righteousness. Let Him reprove them of sin. Convince them of righteousness and judgment. Let's pray. Let's pray. Holy Spirit, let your work of conviction have free course in the heart of everyone in my locality. Lord God Almighty, I thank you for this teaching again. Dear Holy Spirit, I call on you today. Do your three works by convincing, by reproving, by opening the eyes of everyone in my local assembly and in my community and in my nation to know the pending doom that awaits sinners, the judgment that awaits sinners. Convince them, my Father, reprove them of sin. Open their hearts to know that judgment, severe judgment, eternity in hell is waiting for all that we follow the devil to do evil. Let them see the reason to live a righteous life. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord, as we have spoken in your ears today, do unto us in Jesus' name. Dear Holy Spirit, carry on your work in our nations. Reprove people of sin. Convince them of judgment and of righteousness to the praise of your majesty. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please let us sing Him 3.
Mix me wider. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it rain.